This video tutorial I will explain Spring Boot log4j2 properties example. Spring Boot default logging uses logback, and if you want to configure log4j2, first we have to remove Spring default logging dependency, which is logback. Using exclusion stack I have removed here, and then we have to add log4j2 dependency. And here I have added log4j2 dependency. Here you can see log4j2.properties file. In this file I have configured logging related stuff, and here I am using console appender. And if you want to change the log level, here you can change. You can change to debug or info or warning, etc. And we have to place this file inside the resources folder of the project. Here you can see the Spring Boot project. Log level I have configured as info. Here I have defined a class Hello World application, which is Spring Boot application. Inside main method I am printing debug level log, info level log, warning level log and error level log. And it has Hello World method. To call this method we have to send request to this path. I am running this application. Here we have configured info level log. So info level log is printing, and warning and error level logs are less than info level log, so those are also printing. I am changing to debug. I am running this application again. Now you can see debug level log also printing. Next I will call this method by sending a request to this path, and we will see this info level log will be printing. Here you can see the output, and here you can see the info level log has been printed. You can get Java source code link from the description of the video. In mobile, to see the description, click on this icon. It will expand like this, and here you can see the description. It contains Java source code links. Click on these links to get the Java source code.